I grew up in a family of teachers. My mom was a teacher in CIT. My grandparents were teachers. I have uncles and aunties who are teachers, and some of my cousins are teachers. I grew up in a compound in Guadalupe. Tanghan kayo in a teacher. After high school, actually, I told my mom, "Mom, I'm never gonna be a teacher." And then I took up the course, Bachelor of Science in Computer Science. And then I graduated. After graduation, I got confused and then entered the NGO world. And 7 years after, I became the advisor of the Young Minds Academy of Ramon Aboitiz Foundation Incorporated. And what do I do? I'm just like a teacher. I've been working with young people since I was in college. Through the student council, and after college, I became the project coordinator for the Circles of Discernment for Empowerment at Lea Tan Foundation, mostly dealing with young people. And then after Lea Tan in 2013, I became the program officer for youth development at the Ramon Aboitiz Foundation Incorporated. In my 7 years journey dealing with young people like you, I met a lot of inspiring young people that made me want to do some more, and then made me aspire of a Philippines that is better than what we have now. So I came up with 5 reasons why you young people, should join and do contribute something in the community. And I'm going to start with this. Creativity and innovation. The reason why I love my job is that it's very rare that you get a job that where you see and hear young people think of creative and doable projects for the community. Meet Hillary, Faith, Seth, Rupert, and Kyle. These were the Young Minds Academy scholars last year. They made this Masters of Disaster board game. This Masters of Disaster board game, gihimo ni siya kay ganahan sila mutabang sa mga bata sa barangay Basak, Lapu-Lapu City sa pag-increase sa ilahang level of awareness on disaster preparedness. This board game was a very creative way in educating young people something that is very complex, no, like disaster risk reduction and management. And they really had fun doing the game. So after the tournament that they implemented, the students and the school thanked them because this is just so much fun. And then this year, the same team, they wanted to help the kids in their community, you know? They think that their kids in their community kay wala tayo kaon, no? Merdaghan ang mga malnourished children. So they went to Carbon Market, and then they asked the association in the Carbon Market if they can get the rejected vegetables. Of course, they made sure that the vegetables are still good to eat and are clean, no? So they gather the rejected vegetables. The vegetables undergo a certain process, and then after that, they made soups out of it. No? They call their project soup of the ordinary. So they've already made two batches or two flavors of soup. They package it in a way nga nindot kaayo, and then they sell these soups to health buffs, no? Health individuals. Kanang ganahan mga gym, they sell it. And then after selling it, the profit all, of course, goes to the feed, to the kids. So Hillary, Faith, Seth, Rupert, and Kyle are just 14 to 17 years old. Who are 14 to 17 years old here? They raise their hands. They always want to make me ask myself, nagunsa magkuwag ng pag 14 years old na ko. Young people like you are innovative and creative. You think of things that is out of the ordinary. So, it has always been a challenge in the Young Minds Academy, and we challenge our students na you think out of the box because you are our future leaders. If you are our future leaders, and if you're thinking of running for SK, you do not want to have the same projects over and you want to create innovative and doable projects and creative projects for the community. Innovative projects that work. Innovative projects that are not of the ordinary. Because you are young and you are creative and innovative. Number two is full of energy. You know, young people like you, maybe last night you went out drinking and then coming home late at night, and then in the morning you wake up very early because you have classes at 7, and still you have the energy to do all these things. I want you to meet Roxanne Hernandez. Roxanne is already working. She is doing organizational development, making frameworks and doing all the serious stuff for the organizations. Roxanne launched and initiated the Technologian Leaders Academy in CIT. For 5 years already, the Technologian Leaders Academy has been going on in the university, and then they already have a lot of student graduates who became leaders, and these students were really very grateful of in the program. This year, and I think they started last year, they are already replicating the Technologian Leaders Academy in the different schools and universities in Cebu. I also want you to meet Aldrin and Mikey. Aldrin and Mikey, they're both graduates of YMA, and also they went to the Netherlands and Belgium for a cross-cultural immersion called the Young Minds on Explore. After their trip, they came back here. They were so inspired, and they wanted to do something for the community. So this year, they launched the Federation Youth of Basak project in Barangay Basak, Lapu-Lapu City, and one in Pisa called the Action Kabataan, both disaster risk reduction and management and climate change adaptation projects. They want to channel the energy of the youth to become good citizens and DRRM-ready citizens. So, Roxanne, Aldrin, and also Mikey, they're full of energy. And you guys, you're also full of energy. That's why I think you're here, because you want to be inspired. Because you have so many energies, you want to make use of these energies, to put these energies into action and progress. Number three is the ability to inspire. The reason why I'm here is because I believe that the youth, and you have your own potential in inspiring young people and even adults in doing action for the community. I want you to meet Kristen Cabana. Kristen he won this grant from a foundation, and then he helped a community in the Ating community in Naga City. You know where Naga City in Cebu? Yes, it's in the south of Cebu. So he went almost every day in the community to teach them basic hygiene. And after they got the grant, they created this system, this water system, so that they can have potable water in the community. Kristen is also very active in doing other projects, no, and other youth-related projects. And he founded the Project Notebooks. I also want you to meet Maggie. Maggie is so dear to me. I met her at Ilaab Foundation. Maggie was once a street child when she was still little. She worked her way through college with the help of Ilaab Foundation Incorporated. After college, she is now starting her own project, helping her fellow street children. No? She is now leading a project, helping street children go back to school. She is exercising with them every day. She's teaching them basic hygiene. And above all, she is helping them find God through catechism. She devotes every day of her life and even her Saturdays to meet these kids so that she can teach them and tutor them sa ilang mga next lessons. And then she also got a pool of volunteers to help them. And if you want to volunteer, please let me know, because I can take you there this Saturday. Next Saturday. joy and happiness. Sa tanan akong nailhan nga nihimo og community-based programs or projects sa community or the involved of organizations nga naay kalambigit sa pag-serve sa community, I found out that all of them are doing it because they find joy and happiness in what they are doing. When I asked Maggie, she said, why is it that you really do what these things? Because these things, you already graduated, you could get a job with a higher pay, but then why are you doing this? She said, I continue what I am doing, particularly accompanying street children, because despite feeling and knowing their pains, I find so much joy in what I am doing. Number 5 is meaning and hope. I have been dealing with the millennials for quite a while. I'm even a millennial myself. I'm a very problematic person. So, millennials, when you say millennials, people would really think, and when you say millennials, you don't really get a lot of positive things, no? But I believe that the millennials could actually do some things to change the course of our country. That if we invest more and more to our youth, the daghan pa jud ang pwede nga ma-develop sa atoang nasun. This year, Rafi Yancy conducted a study on the well-being of the youth, and I need to read this because it's a... Where is that? Okay, just recently, Rafi Yancy conducted a study on the aspirations and well-being of the youth of Cebu. The research was done to determine other intrinsic factors that influences the well-being, life satisfaction, and aspirations of the youth. I couldn't give you all the data that we got, but I'll just share to you some of the data that really got through me and really had me questioning a lot of questions, no? Had me to ask some more questions. We found out that 7 out of 10 youth are physically well, are able to do cognitive tasks, feel confident, and are able to adjust and adapt in the community, which is okay. It is good that 7 out of 10 youth are physically well. The next thing is that 3 out of 10 youth are emotionally well or are able to control their anger. So only 3 out of 10 youth, I asked. How about the 70% of the youth? Okay, when I ask you guys here, are you emotionally well? Sometimes, kasi natitingnan lang mo na pag-aas ang inyo, kay bugod kayo ang mga youth ba, no? This is somehow mind-boggling that only 3 out of 10 youth would say that they are emotionally well or they can control their anger. We also found out that only 5 in every 10 youth have done community projects or are civic conscious. On a separate study by the National Youth Commission, of course, this is something that they do every 5 years, I think. They found out that 26% of the youth all over the Philippines think that life was not worth living. So 1 in every 4 young people think that life was not worth living. 14% have considered taking their life, engaged in steps to push through it. So you can just imagine, a 14%. So that's actually gamay has yet tan-aw sa percentage, but it's actually a lot. That's why I really like the talk of DJ ganina. No, you need to listen. If you have friends, no, if you have friends or you have problems, you talk and then you listen to each other, because that's how you really. That's how we help each other. We also found out that 25.3% have used any form of illegal substance, meaning 1 in every 4 have used any form of illegal substance. They also found out that 70% are not members of youth organizations. So, I asked myself, could there increased number of mental health issues among the youth and the decrease in involvement in well-meaning groups or community service? I don't know. Maybe there is. But we need to do something about this now because this is somehow a big issue already. So, I would just like to tell you, 7 years ago after college, when I joined the NGO world, I felt like this is my calling, that this is a vocation that I am going. At first, that I thought that ako kwan makakontribute jud ko ay ginahan jud kay ko motabang sa uban, that I could do some more, that I could help some more, that I could give hope to other people. But then I was wrong. It was I who benefited some more. Ako ang nakabenepisyo sa akong pagtabang sa uban. Kano man, every time I see young people that I know I have somehow influenced and somehow nakatouch ko sa ilang isa ginagmay lang, I know that I have done my share and that gives meaning and hope in my life. I have been more hopeful for the country and I know that I will never stop doing the things that I do. So I'm still here in front of you, maybe a self-proclaimed teacher because I never passed the board exam and I never had any education units, but I'm really a student, really. A student who is continuously learning because of young people like you. Young people like you who want to listen, young people like you who want to do some more.